Welcome back. You're watching Reporters Diary. Now, the plan is to make financial services more accessible. That's the word from serial investor Sachin Bansal in his first interview after applying for a banking license. Speaking exclusively to Shireen Bhan, the CEO of Navi Technologies added that 80% of the personnel in the banking venture will be techies, and he plans to approach finance with a consumer tech mindset. Here's an excerpt of that conversation.
Universal bank versus a small finance bank, I think this one of the big decisions that we had to take was, do we want to solve for only lower income customers, or do we want to solve for a larger set of audience? The fact is that the problem exists for a very large set of audience. I still believe that even HNIs in India don't really get that great service. I think even the problem exists over there.
Are you facing that problem?
I think bank apps, etc., are not the best, right? So even, they can do much better, right? So
okay.
I would say that, and also the universal bank license gives us the freedom to invest faster.
Okay.
Right? And we have the capital, we have the access to capital, we have the ability to raise more money to be able to invest and scale up faster, and that's what we want.
So are you looking at bringing more investors on board? Are conversations on at this point in time?
There are some conversations going on, yeah.
By when do you hope to close those, and what kind of capital raising are you looking at? What kind of dilution are you looking at?
We can't talk about specifics yet. Discussions are still going on, I would say. But I think we're looking to bring a couple of more people. And these are not just for money, right? So we can bring in, we have enough capital of our own. I can bring my own capital. I am bringing all of my capital into this business, right? But it's more about bringing in people who have built banks, either in India or outside of India, and who can bring that kind of expertise to the table, right? Not just money, right? So money, I think, is more easily available, relatively. But I think it's the expertise which is what we are looking for. I come from a consumer tech background.
Yeah.
I don't know anything about banking, right? So that's something that I'm looking to learn, and I'm learning, although, of course, there will be a pace at which I will learn.
You know, you talked about talent and people with expertise coming on board. You've already got advisors like Paresh Sukthankar of formerly with HDFC Bank, and of course, Nachiket Mor, former director of the Reserve Bank of India. Take me through the kind of team that you hope to build around yourself in order for you to be able to meet this objective.
Yeah, I think this is still work in progress, and my thought process will evolve as it progresses further. But we, of course, at the board level, we are trying to bring a diverse set of people who will bring banking and expertise, core banking expertise, along with technology know-how. But in the team, I'm thinking of more like an 80-20, where we'll bring 20% of the people who will come from core financial services background, who have done and who have been in operating roles in these BFSI companies. Either in India or outside of India, and then we will pair them up with tech-oriented guys who think fresh, who think new, who can think of creative ways of solving
problems. So, there's about 100 people already that are working with you?
Slightly less than 100, but we're building the team.
Okay, you're building the team, but what about the app? The speculation is that you were planning to launch the app in April this year. Is that on course?
We're still working on it, yeah.
So that
it will launch.
April may not be the time.
We'll let you know when it's ready.
But give me some sense of what that will do as and when
it's a very small first step in the whole financial services journey for us. We acquired a microfinance company, and we are building that further, of course. But apart from that, we are launching some digital lending products on top of that. And we are going to be launching that soon.
On that note, we'll slip into a short break. Coming up on the other side, big move to let migrant population vote away from their constituencies. The law ministry moves to allow the election commission to link Aadhaar with voter ID cards. We'll bring you those details on the other side.